Good morning, sir. If you're ready, right hand. Do you solemnly swear the testimony about to give the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help me God?
State your name for the record, sir.
Tevin, correct.
And are you here on behalf of Leland, correct?
Yes.
Can you please tell Judge Hughes the impact of what this incident has had on both Leland and on your family?
Well, I'm reading on behalf of Leland. I am a young black man who was born and raised in all of the USA. Which I have been at. I attended private schools in seventh grade. At the age of 14, my family moved to Jacksonville, Florida, for a different environment. During my first year here in Jacksonville, I met George Davis, for which we formed the brotherly bond that was shattered on November 23rd, 2017. In that tragic moment, my life has been a challenge. Family, school, relationship, even with myself. Dealing with the loss of my best friend, that would have to be mentally and physically depressed at times. I was taught that each individual was given the benefit of the doubt. Those lessons have questioned after the question due to the tragic event, we are no longer done on our part. I feel the maximum sentence should be issued. As a victim of this tragic action, it's been difficult going forward. But as a survivor, I vow to go forward. For myself, my family, and my best friend, Jordan Russell Davis.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Your Honor, at this time, on behalf of Kevin Thompson, we would first start with Carmen Thompson. Oh, we have a statement to read. Then what we're going to do is we're going to ask Ms. Wilson to have a read the statement of Carmen Thompson. And judge again for the record, Kevin,
And Your Honor, this is a statement read by Kevin Thompson. And it's titled, New Beginnings. Honorable Judge, the whole experience has really changed my life. It taught me to see value in life and to cherish our family and friends because you never know when they go. Knowing that bullets could have gone through my door frightens me every day. I thank God every day that he gave me a blessing and protected me that night from those bullets. It's been almost 2 years since the incident happened, and I'm just glad it's finally over and we got justice for my son Jordan. Yours truly, Kevin Thompson.
And then we have another letter to read, Judge Field, and we'll be doing that as well.
And Your Honor, this letter is from the parents of Kevin Thompson. Your Honor, there are no words that we can tell you to explain the pain that we feel every day since the incident happened on November 23rd, 2012. It was very emotional to watch our son on the stand testifying for the murder of his friend. When any of our children leave the house, we tend to worry until they return home safely, because you never know what can happen to them while they're out there, just because of this experience. As parents, you never want to see your child go through such a traumatic situation at such a young age, but it teaches him to be aware of his surroundings, and it teaches us as well. Even though our son is still here, we can see his pain every day and his different emotions. It has changed him in many ways. Sincerely, the parents of Kevin Thompson.
And Judge, I believe something to the letters have already been placed in the record, if not, I'm going to show you what they do. I have two more witnesses, Your Honor, but this time I can call Carolina Davis.
Ms. Davis.